Okay, we are doing MCQs, Atoms and Radioactivity 2019. The questions which I'm supposed to discuss with you. Second question, which observation provides evidence for the nuclear atom? Attraction of opposite charges, emission of gamma rays during the decay of radioactive nucleide, scattering of alpha particles by thin metal foil, scattering of gamma rays by thin metal foil. We have done this Rutherford's experiment. It is scattering of alpha particle, which gives us the evidence of nuclear atom. What does nuclear atom basically means? Nuclear atom means nucleus. The nucleus is in the center and the electrons are there in different orbits. And because here alpha particles are getting scattered in different direction, we have done this in Rutherford's experiment. This is the experiment that gives us the evidence to show that the structure of atom is like a solar system. It is having nucleus in the center. So the answer for this part is going to be C. If there are any questions, you can ask me. Okay, so this is question number 4. There is a radioactive source. The magnetic field is into the paper. The deviation of different particles is shown. Obviously, Y is going straight. So this has to be gamma rays. Now we have to choose for X and Z between alpha and beta. So I'm supposed to choose between this and this. Now see over here, you can make out this here. The deviation is very little. This is possible only if the particles are very heavy. Heavy particles will get deviated less. Here the deviation is very large. It means Z has to be beta particles. And for X, you can see slight deviation is there. Little deviation. Alpha particles are very heavy. X will be alpha particles. Yes. So this is going to be the option. Because here alpha particles are very light, their deviation is very little. You should compare the amount of deviation that is taking place. Y is of course fixed. It has to be gamma rays. For X, the deviation is slight. Here the deviation is very large. X, the deviation is little. These particles are supposed to be very heavy. So X has to be alpha particles. Here the deviation for Z is very large. These particles are very light. They are going to be beta particles. So your correct option over here is going to be B. Any questions? An experiment is done to measure the radiation from a radioactive source that has half-life of 10 minutes. Okay, half-life of 10 minutes is there. The source is placed close to the detector that is connected to the counter as shown. Okay, radioactive source. This is the detector. So this is what is there. The average background. Okay, background counter rate is also given. That is 20. At start of the experiment, the counter rate recorded by the counter is 1000. Okay. This is very easy. It's similar to that question that we have done for graph. Okay. The counter rate is 1000 in the beginning. From that, I'm going to subtract the background count rate, which is 20. So original count rate due to radioactive substance only should be 980 counts per, what is the unit they have given?
Yes.
Okay, counts per minute. Okay, it is this only. See, I'm repeating this last part. Original count rate is 1000. This is what is given. 20 is the background radiation. So original count rate due to only radioactive substance will be 980. After 10 minutes, that is after half-life, this count rate, 980 should become half. So this is going to become 490 counts per minute. This is without counting the background radiation. The background radiation has to be there, that you never forget to add that. So this count rate is going to become 510 counts per minute. Your answer for this question is going to be C. If there are any questions, same procedure I have followed, which we had done that background radiation by graph. This question is without graph. What I've done over here, I've taken the original count rate, 1000 counts, subtracted background count rate. I get this count rate because of only radioactive substance. Make half of that, half life after 10 minutes, 980, half of that is 490, but here also background radiation is going to be there, and then you add that. This is how I get the answer. Just take that down.
Yes, sir.
My another question, additional question over here is, this question we have finished. Now I'm asking over here, what is going to be the count rate after 20 minutes?
Okay. Should I write it in the chat?
Yeah. Calculate this, write this in your book. And instead of this question, I'm changing it. Of course, this option may not be applicable. Okay. These options will not be applicable. You have to work out this answer on your own and send this answer to me. Okay, question number 16. The diagram shows beta particles being directed between the poles of a magnet. Beta particles are going from right to left. The magnetic field that is there is north pole to south pole, that is up to down. What we are supposed to determine is in which direction will the alpha will the particles be deflected. We are having beta particles over here. Okay. Now one thing you should remember over here, the magnetic field is from up to down. Beta particles will never get attracted either towards north pole or towards south pole. So these both answers are not possible. Bottom of the page or top of the page. You just have to think over here, into the page or out of the page, by applying Fleming's left hand rule. So I'm going to use my left hand. I'll just shoot that video and we will get this answer. Okay, now over here I've used the same video over here. Okay. I'm using here, this is my first finger up to down. North pole to south pole. Correct. North pole is here, south pole is here. This is the direction of magnetic field up to down. North pole, south pole, first finger. The middle finger is going to be with the direction of current. Current is flow of conventional current, which is flow of positive charges. Now this rule that is applied, it is for alpha particles. Remember here, this finger, this is my middle finger, direction of current. This is C, direction of current, direction of conventional current. Conventional current is flow of positive charges. But beta particles are negative. So whatever is the direction of thumb, we will make for alpha particles opposite. The thumb is going into the page. So alpha particles, if it is there, it will go inside the page. Beta particles will come out of the page. So your option over here is going to be B.